上，但却无法否认各事实的存在。这种现象虽曾出现在某些宗教中，但极其罕见而珍贵，而求道之人除信道不笃于反道败德者，不敢定论外，其余则比比皆是。肉身既显似瑞香，足可证其灵性已登善境，当无疑问。二人虽不为万物之灵，其实是很脆弱的。自从生在各世界上，就难免天灾人祸的威胁，甚多以求道者，在遇到人力不可挽救之危急情况下，诚心使用三宝，皆能大事化小，小事化无。这种例证多得不可胜数，无法在此一一例举。以上两点虽然极为宝贵，但却是任何人只要一求道，借着上帝的天命宝贵，立刻就可以得到的保障。此后就随个人的诚心智慧及对真理之实践，而有或深或浅不同的体验了。如人饮水，冷暖自知。希望各位具有善根，有机会能得闻大道的先生女士，皆能入宝山而满载而归，皆能求道而同真善境。
Introduction to DAYI. What is DAYI? D-A-N-M-E-I-I-I. What it is in DAYD. What do I get in RECIV and in DALV? What do we need to receive DALVI?What impact does receiving DAO have on MEVII? What can attest the validity of DAOI? What is DAO observing the cosmos and all the living beings consciously, among all the earthly activities and phenomena, we will find the existence of the laws of nature.There is a supernatural origin which guides all the operations happening across the galaxy, the Earth, and the human beings. We call this source Dao. Dao existed before primordial time, and even before the universe was merged.It is the origin of the world, and it thereafter nurtures all the creatures and beings. Since it is unchangeable and does not evolve with time, it is the ultimate truth. It is what all saints and sages throughout human history had been searching for. The essence of Tao is the foundation of nature.The law or the power that existed before the universe was formed is beyond description, because there were no civilizations nor creatures, let alone languages. Since it cannot be applied any name, we simply call it Tao. After the world was merged, along with the mutations of the universeWe see the harmonious actions as exhibited in seasonal changes, rhythms of time and tide, and the balance of the ecosystem. We also find some conformity of human nature across various cultures. These prove the laws of nature. This is the extension of that original Tao when it is substantiated and materialized. It merged into everything that is with and within us. Now that we know Tao is present universally and yet difficult to be recognized, There have been prophets and preachers trying to make us know and understand the origin and the truth of life through various teachings and literature since the beginning of civilization. They were scattered around the world throughout history. As a result, great commandments were taught to disciples and goodness and badness were differentiated. These teachings varied, based on differences in culture, background, timing and the level of each individual's comprehension. However, they all tried to express and transmit to their descendants this creator and chief of the universe. It is God, or what we call Tao. As we get to know it more and more, we will realize that the essence of Tao and its effect covers every existence without any exceptions. Tao is actually the headwaters of all religions. It embraces the essence of all the preaching and teachings. And yet, it is superior to the system of belief. It is the nature, the universe itself. Tao or God represents the highest authority and power of nature. It is also the headstream and superior to all. It is the unchangeable principle. Understanding Tao allows us not only to discover the center of all religious belief, but also to communicate with the origin and the highest power of nature. We will then be able to relate ourselves to the truth of the universe. To probe further, Tao existed before the formation of all, yet it was not anterior, which means that the creation was embedded in it. Tao emerges into the creation, yet is not posterior, which means that it is not thereafter limited. Among those created, however large, they can be measured, however small, they can be detected. It is only Tao that cannot be measured of its immensity nor detected of its existence. Therefore, it is larger than the largest and leaves nothing excluded, and yet it can be smaller than the smallest and leaves nothing not penetrated. It is ubiquitous. It merges into and governs all. It is in charge of the space, the earth, human beings, all the creatures, and all existences. It penetrates and regulates the entire universe. It is the source of all the scriptures, sutras, as well as dharmas. It encompasses all the religions, and it is what makes one a Buddha or a saint. It is the single chief of all. And, above all, it is in charge of each individual too. It is the divine self. This is the true meaning of Tao. We should get to know it this way and rediscover our own invaluable treasure. So, to practice Tao is to revive one's own conscience as well as everyone's, and to act upon it accordingly. Then, all people can be of one spirit, all nations can be in peace like a family, and the great harmony will come true. How precious Tao is! Dao and me. The significance of Tao is in its immensity and ubiquity. Its enormous guides the universe to carry on with changing seasons and evolving creatures. The countless aspects of the natural phenomena seem so capricious and yet really in order and in cycles. This almighty being also resides in each of us. It is the divine self, the natural quality of a person. It enables us to see, to feel, to taste, to hear, and to move without learning. While we research the ultimate truth in the universe, we should turn in upon and see into ourselves to discover that divine self. We will find the rules that govern the universe also comply with the way we are. Tao is not something too far to reach, nor too mysterious to comprehend. It is nothing particular, but has to do with our daily lives. We cannot do without it. Every movement we make, in order to see, to touch, to feel and to think, is associated with Tao. Consider how many wonders are hidden in our body, how delicately our physical functions are carried out. For example, when we shake hands, the components involved would include the coordination of joints and muscles, the chemical reactions of energy, the transmission of information through nerve systems, and the actions occurring in our brain such as issuing orders, making judgments and analyzing situations. Even with the most advanced technology and the highest level of knowledge we have developed today, we cannot completely reconstruct such a function. Yet the ability to perform such a simple movement is there for all individuals, regardless of the level of a person's knowledge and his/her being a grown-up or a baby, a scholar or an illiterate. Theses are the kind of abilities we come equipped with naturally, without learning and being taught. It sits within us and is in charge of all. It is Tao, never diminishes nor inflates. Worldly knowledge acquired through learning can be forgotten. A gymnast can abandon his/her techniques and a musician can lose his/her skills without practicing. The essence of Tao and its extension are always in charge of the macro universe, the nature, and the micro universe, the human being's self. We are associated with it unconsciously since the first day. Because it encompasses the whole nature within us, we also call it native self. Tao is within and surrounding us. It needs not be worshipped nor debated over. Because its existence is unconditional, regardless of race, color, nationality, religion or status. It is impartial and stays constant. In receiving Tao, we not only find the origin of the universe, but also the divine self. We get to know the highest power in the universe as well as the genuine nature in charge of self. We discover the ultimate truth of the cosmos as well as the integrity of ourselves. Recognizing that the laws which govern the universe also govern us makes us be able to return to our true nature. To probe further, the most essential concept in Tao is that we all possess it intrinsically. It is the wisdom and ability we were born with without learning or practicing. It is one's conscience, which is like the spirit of God, the divine and immortal nature. It is invisible and intangible. For this reason, we call it genuine emptiness, which means that to be really empty, it goes beyond emptiness and can therefore have marvelous existence in it. Marvelous existence is the foundation for the sky, the earth, human beings, all the creatures, and all existences. With omnipotence, Thou is called Great Lord of all beings. This Almighty Being is not only in charge of the entire universe, but also in charge of oneself. So the proverb is, Thou is within self, which is the drive of all one's abilities. A physical body without Thou is useless. This is the treasure that we should all realize and fully explore. What it is in Dao. When we look around the world, we admire the miracles and wonders of nature. Countless things change and move simultaneously every second, and yet in order and in harmony. So do our bodies. Countless biochemical reactions and physical functions occur concurrently within our bodies. Without learning and thinking that come subjectively, the thousands of activities that happen within us are the extension and action of Tao. And altogether, it is one single self. It functions naturally and automatically without the need for our intents to be involved. This is the effect of Tao within us. Tao is not only in control of the universe and nature, but also in charge of every human being in his/her own actions. In other words, it is the same source that governs us as well as everything else. Tao is invisible and intangible, but it has been working out its magic before day one. Thereafter, languages, cultures, religious scriptures, literature, and civilization were developed. They all originate from Tao functioning within us. People don't realize it is Tao that has been residing and working within us and have used soul to represent the confusing and yet irrefutable being. Because it is eternal and intangible, we also call it true self. This true self is the most abundant, brilliant, and imperishable being. Let us take a look at our tangible body and see if it can be the true self. We know the pictures taken throughout one's life show different faces and expressions. We recognize people by face, but our looks change and are not permanent. The handicapped, with impaired arms or legs, can also lead a complete life. One with a transplanted animal heart is still a human being. Even our brain cells keep decreasing and changing every second from the moment we were born. Therefore, the physical body is only the interim residence of the true self. Though it seems so real, solid and alive, it turns into dirt eventually. We call it false self because of its tentative and transient nature. By recognizing the difference between the true self and the false self,